Assalamu alaikum, Hazur.
Hazur, first, if I like to start with one question. If that is
as an appetizer before the, you know.
If that is sufficient for the whole evening, I don't know the answer.
Let's see.
Up to the time of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih the First, the members of Anjuman Ahmadiyya Ishaat-e-Islam Lahore, as I understand, had the same beliefs as the Jamaat Ahmadiyya Mubayyin, that is, those who remained loyal to Khilafat. But afterwards, they held different beliefs, to my knowledge. Would Hazur kindly explain?
Excuse me. The first statement on which you want to build the question is not correct, unfortunately. It was during the first caliphate, that is Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal's time, that they had already surfaced with a distinct set of beliefs. And repeatedly they were reprimanded by Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu, and they were kept under strict harness for a while. But afterwards, as the death approached, then they started creating sort of fitna so openly that it became a very prominent issue at that time. So, that to say that they changed their beliefs after the death of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu is not exactly right.
Yes, yes, yes.
They got separated officially with full declaration, that is clear. But the beliefs they had sustained, in fact, these beliefs with an undercurrent of differences with Khilafat. It all started with that. And now, keeping this state of affairs in view, now you can frame your question, what the question is.
My question is, would Hazur kindly explain the change in their beliefs and reasons thereof, especially for the new converts and younger generation, as they still believe the promised Messiah as a reformer for this age and also accept the books of the promised Messiah.
Right, please sit down. As I briefly mentioned, their differences started with Khilafat, in fact. And they started with a particular person, in fact, whom they thought, they feared, would become the future Khalifa for the Jamaat. So they were afraid of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Thani, that is Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad, to become the Khalifa, because he was like a rising star, so obvious and prominent that everybody, if not started talking, at least started entertaining such views as some kept to their mind and some did not about his possible Khilafat. So because these particular people who were opposed to him, they entertained personal enmity and personal jealousy of Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad Sahib. So they started talking. Now once they realized during this process of difference of opinion that whatever they do, this young man is willy-nilly going to become a Khalifa after the death of Hazrat Masih Awwal. They started justifying their difference with him. The only way they could wriggle out of this difficulty was to start preaching about the institution of Khilafat and propagating that this was not necessary, because as long as the institution of Khilafat remained there, they had absolutely no choice to replace Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu and choose one of the Khalifas which of their own liking. So this was the first defeat accepted by them positively realizing that this game is lost, and then changing their stance to principles instead of personalities. And this was a better looking way of opposing him, obviously. It had some nobility if you differ in principles rather than in personalities. So anyway, they started propagating that we accepted Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal رضي الله تعالى عنه as a person, the most pious man. Otherwise, as far as the rights inherited from Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam are concerned, those rights belong to Anjuman. This was the first seed of dissension that they sowed. Now, this further developed, and concept further developed, and they started saying that Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal was a spiritual man, highly spiritual, and was an exceptional character. So, Anjuman, it was the Anjuman who chose him. But it was not that the Anjuman gave up the right for choosing forever. For one particular instance, the Anjuman decided to give her powers over to a certain person. So they were in a way delegated powers. And the Sadr Anjuman still retains the power of being the true inheritors of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam's authority for all times to come. Secondly, they started saying that the powers which Anjuman enjoys, in fact, are the powers which evolve from a system. And it is a democratic age, and this is the democratic system which Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has given to the community, confirming to the dictates of time. When they started saying it, the reason was that if they wanted to do away with Khilafat, they had to do away with Nabuwat as well. Because if they accepted Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam as a prophet, then a prophet never leaves his authorities to a democratic elected anjuman or things like that. There is no evidence in the past prophethood that ever a prophet delegated his powers to a body of people who were to be elected democratically later on. So that was the main difficulty which arose in the way of establishing this view. With the result that the second step had to be taken. It was unavoidable. So they started murmuring later on that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam was a prophet in a very remote sense. In reality he was not. And because Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, while addressing certain opponents who propagated about him that he claimed to be an independent prophet, independent of Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, had rejected this view outright in the strongest terms. And if you read just those passages of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, not knowing to whom he is addressing, you may infer yourself that perhaps he is rejecting that concept of Nabuwat altogether in him. He is disclaiming himself to be a Nabi in any way. In some strong passages, if somebody has a set inclination of thinking, he can infer from that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam is disclaiming. So they brought those passages to limelight and said, look here, this is obviously the position. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam never claimed to be a prophet in the true sense. By Zilli prophet he meant a prophet of a sort, you know, which was not really a prophet. So, they also took refuge in some other writings of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, which spoke about Muhaddis and Muhaddiseen. And he said that there were previous Muhaddiseen in the Ummah. So when he speaks of Muhaddis as a prophet, obviously he is one of those and not at all an exception. So this is how they completely somersaulted and turned volta face, and in fact they got renegated from the Jamaat. But during the lifetime of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal, this attitude was tolerated to certain extent to keep them within the community and to reform them. But whenever things went too far, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal had to talk to them in strongest terms. Some of those sermons are famous and have been oft quoted in Jamaat Ahmadiyya's Khilafat Day speeches, in which he very clearly tells them that these views are totally wrong, they have nothing to do with Ahmadiyya. So, at the time of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal's death, Hazrat Muslim Maud, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, knowing that originally their differences had all emanated from their personal dislike of him, offered them this proposition that if they accept in principle the institution of Khilafat, he himself would propose the name of Maulana Muhammad Ali or anyone on which they agree, so that we will save a schism in the community, as well as we'll also save the fundamental principles of the community. But they knew that they had gone already too far. If they immediately accepted it at that time, everybody would see that their game was personal and illogical, and it had egotistic motives, and they were not talking of principles. So that was the main difficulty. But apart from that, their impression, which they had earlier received, was correct, that Jamaat was in no mood of choosing anyone but Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Ahmad. So the rift started from there.